Today I am going to discuss one topic from electromagnetic field theory, that is relation between Cartesian and cylindrical coordinate system. So here, if you want to represent any point in Cartesian coordinate system, then this is your position vector, that is your A, that is Ax, this is the unit vector Ax, capital Ay, this is your unit vector Az, and this is your unit vector. Means in Cartesian coordinate system, there are three planes, x, y, z, and for this, these are three unit vectors, ax, ay, and az, and these three are perpendicular to each other. In cylindrical coordinate system, the axes are rho, phi, and z, and we can represent any point in cylindrical system, that is your A is your AO, this is your unit vector, A phi, and AZ. Now we have to convert this Cartesian system in cylindrical system. So for this we will use projection formula, means how we can project one vector in another vector. Here these are two vectors, that is your A and B, and angle between these two vectors are theta. So if you want to project this vector in this vector, then what you will get, that is your this A cos theta, and this is your scalar projection. So if you want to represent this A cos theta, then this will give you A cos theta is equal to nothing but A dot B unit vector. Just you can take the dot product with the unit vector B. Here you can see A dot B is magnitude of A, magnitude of B, and cos theta. Now we have to find A cos theta. Then A cos theta is A dot B upon magnitude of B, and vector B upon magnitude of vector B is your unit vector. So this is your A dot unit vector B. In same way, we are finding the values of AO, A phi, and AJ. So here AO is your dot product of vector A with unit vector AO. In same way, we will find out for A phi also. A phi dot unit vector A phi. AZ is your AZ dot A unit vector Z. So this is your expression. That is your AX is equal to AX dot AO. AY is your AY dot AO. AZ is your AZ AO. In same way, you can write for A phi. In same way, you can write for AZ. Now, we can write in matrix form. This is your AO, A phi, and AZ. These are the dot product of unit vector. AX dot AO, AY dot AO, AZ dot AO. This is AX dot A phi, AY dot A phi. In same way, AX dot AZ, AY dot AZ, and AZ dot AZ. Now main thing is, now we have to find out the values of this dot product. So if you will take the, if there is two unit vector, that is your A unit vector and B unit vector, and angle between this unit vector is theta, then if you want to find out the dot product of this two unit vector, then this will give you cosine of angle between these two unit vector, because the magnitude of unit vector is 1. So now, main is your, just you can find out the angle between the unit vector. So to understand this one, you can see this is your point that represents x, y, z. Now you can project this point in x, y plane at this point. Now you can join this point with origin, that will give you rho, and this rho is nothing but radius of the cylinder. And this phi angle is with x axis. Now you can see this is your rho, so this unit vector is along this radial direction. This is A rho. This is Ax. Ax is your unit vector along this x axis. This is your Ay. Ay is along y axis. This is your parallel. Now you can see this A rho and A phi. These two vectors are perpendicular. So here this is 90 degree. Now you can see the angle between x and rho is or ax dot a rho. This one angle is phi, so this will become cos phi. A y and a rho, a y 90 minus phi, cos 90 minus phi is your sin phi, and this is your ax and a rho. This is 90 degree and this is your cos 90 plus phi. This is minus sin phi and y and phi. A y and a phi angle is phi. So this will represent cos phi. Z and rho, these are perpendicular, so this is 0. Z and phi, perpendicular, 0. This is your 1. This is 0 and this is 0. Okay, thank you.